Hey there, Falcon fans. This is Stickstar. I wanted to show you something fun that you can do using Falcon's multi capabilities. So as you're probably aware, you can load as many parts in Falcon as you like. And what you'll see here in the parts in my Falcon instance, you're going to see that there are 5 parts loaded right now. And each is a different set of samples for a 707 drum set. And now, it's very easy to load these up. Of course, you can load these samples into one key group and process them all together. But splitting them up gives you a lot more sonic capabilities per set of drums. I'm actually doing something on top of that here, which is rather than processing these in Falcon, I might want to process these in my DAW, where I'm used to doing maybe more of my mixing work. I have a different set of plugins that I like to work with. And although Falcon has incredible capabilities for this, I might want to use some of the audio plugins that I have available in my DAW in order to make my track the way that I like. So what I'm doing here is you'll notice that all of the parts are being triggered by the same channel. So channel A1 or MIDI channel 1 on the A bus is all triggering all of these samples. So I don't have to use different controllers or different channels for that. They're all set to the same one. But when you look at the output, what you're going to see is the kick drum is going to the first output, which is always the main out. And then I have a different output set for each of these other sets of samples. Now I can play them on the one keyboard. So you can see that they're each coming to different outputs. Now, why is that useful? Well, let me show you. If I go over here and close this, you'll see I'm running Pro Tools, but this will work in any DAW that you like. You'll notice that for my input, I've got basically my Falcon instrument here on the Falcon track, and that is where the main output is coming from. I'm feeding that to the track here, which is Falcon 1, and that is my kick drum. And then for each of these other tracks, Falcon 2, 3, 4, and 5, I've taken the input from output from Falcon out 2, 3, 4, and 5. Those I won't be able to show those to you since I'm recording this live on the same DAW that I'm using. But if I were to click this menu, I'd be able to find my plugin there and then look for the Falcon out 2 in order to take the input to this track. All 5 of these are going to the drum mix, and then the drum mix is going to my mix bus, and I can do all the processing that I like that way. So just to show you that this is working, I'll just play the drums here for a second. Okay, nothing great about my finger drumming there, but there you go. So this is a neat way that you can use the multi-outs in order to set up your drum set the way you like. Now, you probably have seen other drum plugins that will do things like this. So, for example, if you're used to Easy Drummer, you will find that you can do that exact same thing in Falcon. In other words, you could send the different parts of the patch. You can separate them into parts, send each part to a different output, and now you can record those and mix those in your DAW the way that you like. So hopefully this will help you use Falcon even more successfully in the future. I hope you have a lot of fun with Falcon, and until then, I will see you next time.